Thank you, Lord, for the warning. Let us draw close to comfort you and pray for our lawmakers. My family, the Lord has asked me to call you to his side to comfort him. He is so broken over these murderous laws the states are passing. Sweet Jesus, please show us how to best bring you comfort. He began speaking. He said, My people, the laws you are signing into existence are tragedy beyond your reckoning. This is forcing the Father's hand, Sodom and Gomorrah. For those of you who care, please come to my side and hold me, stroke my hair and comfort me, and weep with me, my people. Weep also for yourselves, for great is the calamity my Father will allow for this heinous crime. Everyone involved in this practice, from the doctors to the hospital, to those who make arrangements for disposal of children, everyone who touches this is guilty of first-degree murder. If you work in a hospital where this is going on, leave and find other work. The judgment of the Father is hanging heavily over those who permit this in their hospitals. You are turning this nation into a nation of vampires, where soon anyone will be able to purchase blood, the blood of newborns. It is already a fact on the black market. It started out with the elites, but has spread throughout your government as Satan harvests the blood of innocents in retaliation for shutting down child trafficking rings and building a wall to prevent smuggling victims across the borders. I cannot even begin to tell you the consequences of these crimes. Pray that your president acts immediately to stop this butchery. Pray that he exhausts every possible course of action to shut this down, or these places will be no more. You lawmakers who have signed this into existence, wail and mourn, for your time is coming, and there is no escape from it. Your place in hell is secure unless you repent of this evil and work to overturn these laws. The life you look forward to for your children is in jeopardy. For your criminal slaughter of my children, whom I brought into this world to bless, you will find the Asian, the Arab, the African and Native and Hispanic population will change the face of this nation as their families increase and mature. They will come to maturity and govern with godly values. And those of you who care nothing for life will be in the minority and under their rule in America. I will bless those who honor the sanctity of life. I will cover them and their families with extraordinary protection, and they will multiply and flourish. But for you who murder my children from the womb, God's judgment is upon you and your future generations. Those who honor the sanctity of life, I shall bless and protect. I am warning you that unless you repent and change these laws, judgment will indeed fall upon your house and beyond to your future generations. My people, pray for your president, pray for your lawmakers, pray for a complete reversal of this crime against humanity. Pray the whole world outlaw abortion. And as you stand for them, I will stand for you, and your children I will save. And in closing, I'd like to thank those of you who have been supporting our ministry. We appreciate it so much. And these times can be a little lean, so we're very, very grateful for what you've sown into the ministry. And we are taking care of a lot of charities if you want to see, especially trafficked children who we're taking care of. Go ahead and go to our heartdwellers.org website and click on the outreach tab, and you'll see basically what we're doing. And in addition to that, I just wanted to remind you that our new book, When God Heals and When He Doesn't, is available on Amazon. Or if you drop me a postcard or a letter, I will send you a copy for free. Our goal is not to make money on books, but to get God's word out. So we're not interested in the money aspect of it, and we want to make these available to as many people that need them. Just let us know and we'll send you a copy. God bless you, dear family, and thank you. Thank you for your prayers and for taking care of us. Amen.